already. Based? Red pill? What does it even mean? What does it mean?
You're gonna pull up.
Eh, you. Yeah, you small child that I see randomly wandering the internet. Are you, looking to make an abusive relationship in a story and you don't want to glorify it and have people get seriously angry with you because you're glorifying abuse? Well, you've come to the right bunny person. Pleased to meet you.
I forbid you to take another step down these stairs!
Okay.
Anyways, besides that horribly cringy intro, I had a whole thing written out of how I was gonna do this thing, and then I kinda just stopped liking it, and I kinda threw it to the trash, so now I'm just randomly talking, and, please, this is gonna be a very serious video, but yet I'm gonna be talking very stupidly, because that's just me. And, please, trigger warnings, because they are very important. This is going to be talking about abuse, abusive relationships, and everything to do with abuse, physically, mentally, and sexually. So if you do not want any of that in your life, I would heavily recommend leaving my YouTube channel, because I have a lot of abusive stuff on my YouTube channel. So, like, if you're not into that, please just adios. I have one or two cutesy things, and that's it. So, you're thinking about that one story that you've had in the back of your mind forever, and it is glorious! But, there's one thing holding you back. There's abuse in it. Now, a lot of people get triggered by things relatively easily. And please keep in mind, this entire video is my own opinion. If you share a different opinion, that is completely fine. But, a lot of people get triggered by things really, really, really easily. And so now you have to be ultra careful about things you do on the internet, and I don't know. But you want an abusive story, but you don't want to glorify it. But now you have people claiming that everything is glorifying abuse. I mean, just look at the Dolly Gut situation. They thought she was glorifying abuse when in reality she was actually doing anything but the sort. She was actually showing that her character was not okay with the abuse, but please, I guess we don't care about that. And there's also the Scootaloo Love Sands drama, or the Cine Bear 03, I think was her name. Please, I am horrible with names. But people are now claiming she is promoting abusive relationships with her story, and she may or may not. I don't know. To be honest, I do not keep up with that drama, nor do I have the energy to. But anyway, let's continue. So, you want to have an abusive relationship in the story, but yet you do not want to glorify it. And let's say it's the two main characters. Now, you got a little sticky situation on your hand. But please, listen to Bunny Mama and I will explain to you. And I will never call myself Bunny Mama again. I am the pinnacle of cringe. Now, the first way you do not glorify the abuse is don't make it into a romance comic or show or story. Do not make it into the romance category. That will immediately ruin the entire thing. And hey, there might be one or two that maybe somehow pulled it off in the romance category. But please, I do not suggest it for your sanity and the people that will for sure hate you if you do. No, you got the romance category out of your field. Good job. Now, let's think about what should we do with this relationship. First of all, make sure no one wants to be in it. Make it clear that it's an abusive relationship and no one should ever want to be in it. Make sure that you point out that one of the characters committing the abuse is a piece of trash. And hey, maybe they're not that much of a piece of trash and they accidentally are abusing their partner. Make it clear that they shouldn't be abusing their partner. Make it clear that what they are doing is trash worthy. All right, please do not make the guy character pull the girl character or guy character. Who cares? It could be gay. Don't have him pull the other character out of a social event and be, I just want you all to myself. And make them think, oh my gosh, he loves me. He's just being really cute. No, that's being manipulative. That's being possessive. Do not have them forcibly kiss them and pin them against the wall as they grab them by the wrist and put their arms against the wall. That is highly disturbing. Never do that. Never make it seem like a highly passionate moment and oh my gosh, he just loves me so much he can't help but kiss me against my will. It's disgusting. People like to glorify it a lot in media, such as Korean dramas, where it's so rampant, I can't believe it. Just make it clear. You don't want this, and don't make your other character enjoy it. And if they do enjoy it, at least make it clear that they are anything but right in the head. Make it clear that even if they do enjoy it, it is wrong. Because there are a lot of twisted people that might like it for some reason. But make it clear to the audience that they shouldn't like it. And that that character is messed up or wrong in liking it. And like I said, if that character likes it, just make it clear that that character is being manipulated and being assaulted. Now, here is a really, really, really overused trend that people always do, but they really, really shouldn't. So, you know that typical bad boy situation and that little cutesy girl, and they always get together. And she always goes like, I can fix him, I swear I can. No, do not promote that. You should not be getting in a relationship to fix your partner. You should be getting into a relationship to better your partner. The difference is you're trying to fix your partner by fixing his flaws. By trying to better your partner, you're trying to help, you know, just better, but he's already pretty good how he is, but you just wanna touch up those little things. Don't have the trope where it's the bad boy who's like murdered 50 people and the cutesy ooh-woo girl who just softens his heart and makes him feel so much better and, you know, he pins her against the wall and forces her to make out with him and, oh, it's so romantic. It's not. That's the issue. It's really, really not. But anyway, after my horrendous ramble and terrible crying, and I'm way too energetic to actually be alive right now. It is 3:42 in the morning. Anyways, let's talk about... I forgot what I was gonna say. Alright, anyway, besides my side ramble about whatever I was talking about, you got the characters down. It's not gonna be a romance. It's gonna be a psychological horror, or a sci-fi, or literally anything else but romance, you're good. And you're gonna make the two characters kind of abusive for each other. Oh well, you're not glorifying it, you're not prettying it up. And hey, if you wanna pretty it up, that's fine. But make sure that they still understand that all that pretty dazzled stuff is actually really horrible underneath. Now, if you can kindly look at the speed paint in the background of mine, this is a picture of my OC Oscar. He is in an abusive relationship. Holy crap, did I was not able to talk. Anyway, he's in an abusive relationship with my OC, Michael. I do not try to justify them. Their whole story is a psychological horror. Michael has two different personalities that he got when he was a kid from genetic stuff. And so he's nice to Oscar one day and horribly torturing him the next day. And Oscar has a bunch of issues of his own. Now, I never put them up on a wall and say, look at these boys, they are the pinnacle of a relationship. I mean, I'd love to have Michael hug me and cuddle me to sleep. But anyway, I'm going on a side ramble. If you see the picture in the background, Oscar's all prettied up in whatever outfit I put him in. I swear it's not sexual. But I put him in this outfit But if you look at his thigh, he has a bite mark. And if you look at his eyes, he is crying. Now, I did what a lot of artists do, where they pretty up a really, really dark picture. And I made it dark by making the outside look normal and pretty and even cute. I mean, look at our ooh-woo boy getting ready to cook us a nice meal, but oh no, he's crying and bleeding, and oh no, Michael, what did you do this time? You get the point. I can't talk! Now, if you're an artist and you like to draw everything out, this is a very good tactic you can do. You can make everything look all pretty and nice, but you can tell there is something dark and horrible underneath. It's a very nice thing to do when you're art, and it will subvert expectations. Now, from this point on, I'm probably going to be talking more about my story, so please, let me inflate my ego even more. I'm here to talk about my abusive boys and how I handle them. Now, with Michael and Oscar, as you can tell, I make things clear that everything is not cutesy ooh-woo. I've made multiple animation memes and just animatics of them not being great. Oh, I'll be honest. I make sure people understand that I'm not trying to ship them and make them very cute and ooh-woo and oh my gosh, this relationship is so wholesome. Like, yeah, I'll post a picture of Michael and Oscar giving each other a little smooch and I'll make it really cutesy. And the next, I'll draw Michael drowning Oscar in a bathtub. It's how their relationship works, and it's to show that everything's not as it seems. I mean, the whole story is about this guy stalking this other guy and, well, torturing him, messing with his mind, making him believe he's going slowly insane, and that's why I call it descent into sanity. But I feel like it's very important to just keep your reader constantly on edge and constantly thinking, and hey, if you want to do a slice of life one, but there's just some abuse in it, well, I guess you don't have to constantly keep the reader on edge, but just always just make sure they understand that this is not, you are not promoting abusive relationships, because abusive relationships shouldn't be promoted. Because I guess Koreans can't understand you shouldn't glorify it in romance! please don't mind my screaming into the void. Just screaming some facts. Now, I think I covered most of the things. If I miss some things, please tell me down in the comments. I'm very forgetful. And I would talk about glorifying abuse in art pieces, but that is an entire different topic, and that would make this video even longer than it is, and if you've gotten to this point, I can't believe you watched 12 minutes of a stupid person talking. Thank you very much. But I believe I covered everything, and if I missed something, please tell me, because I don't know. I actually had quite fun making this video. Sorry if you were horribly cringing in your seat at me screaming and talking to myself for like, oh, how long has it been? A while. But thank you all so much for watching. You can see this beautiful speed paint in the background. Took me like 4 hours. It wasn't quick. But thank you so much for watching, and please stick around because I make more cringy stuff and I might start making more talking videos. I really liked this. All right, bye. And remember, I'm not gay to all my friends who call me gay.